Hello and welcome to MahendraGuru.com and you're watching a current affairs express. In the present scenario of examination, the students also want to just minimize their hard work and just want to gain some skills through different types of tubes, and Mahendra represents you so many important videos like reasoning, maths, GA and some other very important subjects. So just go through MahendraGuru.com and subscribe a YouTube channel for important, just for getting benefited from some important videos. Let's move towards a very important news. Australia's prestigious University of New South Wales appointed former Indian diplomat and author Amit Dasgupta as its first India country director. Mr. Amit Dasgupta also played a very important role in External Ministry of India and very important diplomat of India, and also played a role of ambassador in Philippines and some other international country. There are so many questions that can be arise from this information, but one of among all those questions, there is one very important question that can be asked. So let's have a look on that question. Which Indian has been appointed as the director of Australia's prestigious University of New South Wales? So option number one, that is Amit Dasgupta, is the right answer. Let's move towards the next news. RBI appointed Sudarshan Sen as an executive director in place of NS Vishwanathan, who has been elevated as a deputy governor at the central bank. Mr. NS Vishwanathan is among recently appointed as a deputy governor of RBI. So there are four deputy governors of RBI. Among those, Mr. NS Vishwanathan is one of them. And Mr. Sudarshan Sen replaced Mr. NS Vishwanathan, and he takes a follow up very important sections of the RBI, just like some cooperative banks and banking regulations of the RBI. Let's move towards and have a look on a very important question that can be arise from this news is, recently, who has been appointed as the executive director of RBI? So there are five options, and the number one option is NS Vishwanathan. NS Vishwanathan is the number one option, is just to confuse the aspirants, because most of the aspirants going to click that option and just get a negative mark from that question. Because the answer is option number two, that is Sudarshan Sen, because this is a recent phenomena, so most of the aspirants can get confused in this news. Let's have a look on next information. Jawaharlal Nehru Port become the first port in the country to implement logistics data tagging of containers. With this facility, importers, exporters can track their goods in transit through logistic data bank service. Under this technology, they use a thing that is called RIDT, that means radar information detection kind of, and a simple type of a very sensitive tag is just attached with all the containers, and different centers where this technology installed can easily take a sense by all those signals and just trace out the import and exporting material from our country and from the deck. Let's have a look on an important question. Which port become the first port in the country to implement logistics data tagging of container? So option number three, that is Jawaharlal Nehru Port, is very right answer. And there are some other ports which are very important port from the point of view of business and trading in our country with different countries and inside our country from one state to another state. Let's move toward the next news. Abbas Kiarostami, the writer director who recognized Iranian cinema in the world, he was 76. Mr. Abbas was an internationally known director, and he known for his film The Taste of Cherries. In say 1997, he got Palma D Award in Cannes Film Festival. So he recognized Iranian movie in all over the India and played a very pivotal role in the Iran cinema. Let's have a look on a sample question. Abbas Kiarostami is related to which country? So option number four, that is Iran, is the right answer. There are some other country which has a Muslim dominated country, so the aspirants can also get confused among all those countries. Let's have a look on the next news. An Indo-Russian project has been sanctioned by the central government and the Russian Foundation for basic research. So in this news, a very first question that can be raised in examination from the just like abbreviation RFBR, MSUOB, that can be simply asked in examination, what do you understand by RFBR? So the news completely, let me complete the news. To the city-based Maharaja Shivaji University, Baroda, and Banaras Hindu University Varanasi to get improved nuclear data. So all these agreements with all other universities just to enhance, just to raise the level of development of nuclear and nuclear reactions in chemistry. So this is, you can say, a chemistry dominated kind of agreement. Let's have a look on a sample question. In relation to Indo-Russian project, what does RFBR stand for? Let's what I said in the information, that abbreviations is generally and frequently asked in examination and recent news, since it is a recent news, so this can be easily asked in examination. What do you understand by RFBR? So option number 5, that is Russian Foundation for Basic Research, is the right answer. Let's move towards the next news. Football club Mohammedan Sporting bestowed the honor of Shan-e-Mohammedan to former defensive midfielder Prasoon Banerjee. Prasoon Banerjee is a very prolific footballer and very stupendous role played in footballing skills. He's a known brother of legendary PK Banerjee from West Bengal. Let's have a look on a sample question that can be asked. Who was honored with the Shan-e-Mohammedan award by football club Mohammedan Sporting? So option number 3, that is Prasoon Banerjee, is the right answer. In examination, a very important question that can be asked, who is the brother, what is the name of his brother Mr. Prasoon Banerjee, because he was a very known person, Mr. PK Banerjee, and legendary, known as a legendary contribution in football sports. Let's have a look on the next information. Snapdeal becomes the first e-commerce marketplace to introduce services like bus and air ticket booking, etc. On its platform, Snapdeal has launched the services through partnership with Zomato, Cleartrip, Urban Club and Redbus. Snapdeal becomes the first e-commerce. So where the word first attached, this is where there is 80-85% chances that can be asked in your examination, the upcoming examination, like SBI, PO and some SSC, if general affair awareness asked in examination, and coming like RBI and some other insurance sector examination exam. So Snapdeal also proposes a bus and air ticket and some fooding and some lodging. If anyone wants to just book their rooms and food from there, so they can simply go through a Snapdeal and just book all over the things from there. Let's have a look on a sample question. Which of the following has become the first e-commerce marketplace to introduce services on its platform? So option number 1, that is Snapdeal, is the right answer. And in 5 options, if any experience go through this news superficially, so there is a 80-85% chances, or you can say 100% chances, just to go through a wrong click. So we must say that if you go through any information, just go through deeply and have a good knowledge, just to avoid a negative marks in your examination. Let's move towards the end of the section. And under this section, if you want to get benefited from our videos, from our some text, from our some study materials, just like monthly boosters and Mica, just go through mahindraguru.com. We daily updated our sites with the very recent informations and news that are very much beneficial from the point of view of your examination, because your success is our success. Thank you.